Ruskin Bond's Book of Verse, read by Sumit Kaul. Introduction. At the end of the room on the roof, the novel I wrote more than 50 years ago, when I was still in my teens, Rusty and Kishan are trudging back to their home in Dehra. And Kishan says,
"Oh, one day you'll be a writer or an actor or something. Maybe a poet."
"Why not a poet, Rusty?"
And Rusty smiled. He knew he was smiling because he was smiling at himself. "Yes," he said. "Why not a poet?" And that's where the book ends, but not the story. Because Ruskin did become a writer, but having to make a living from the written word, he became a writer chiefly of prose. For as we all know, you can't make a living writing poetry. But poetry remained my first love. And whenever I felt the urge, I put down my thoughts, feelings, and observations into verse form, sometimes slipping these poems into my prose works and anthologies when my publishers weren't looking. I have never had any pretensions to being a serious poet, which is why I prefer to use the word verse to describe my compositions. But I do look upon the world as a poet would. And if there is a lyrical quality to some of my prose, it is probably because the poet in me is trying to break free. Ravi Singh of Penguin India thought it would be a good idea to publish a selection from what I had written over the years, and I thought it would be helpful for the reader if the verses were arranged by theme, with the emphasis on love, nature, childhood, humour, etc. Meru Gokhale has been very helpful with the selection and the arrangement of the verses. Perhaps Krishan, Reed Krishan, was being prophetic when he said,
"Maybe a poet, Rusty?"
Is there still time, I wonder? When we were young, time stretched before us, an infinity of time. It's only we who were finite. The scruffy Kishan of the room on the roof grew into a successful, handsome young man. But he was barely 40 when he perished while saving a child from drowning. To his memory, then, I dedicate this book of verse. Perhaps he, more than any other, brought out the poet in me. Ruskin Bond, 19th February 2007. Love. It isn't time that's passing. Remember the long ago when we lay together in a pain of tenderness and counted our dreams. Long summer afternoons when the whistling thrush released a deep, sweet secret on the trembling air. Black bird on the wing, bird of the forest shadows, black rose in the long ago summer. This was your song. It isn't time that's passing by. It's you and I. Love lyrics for Binya Devi. 1. Your face streamed April rain as you climbed the steep hill, calling the white cow home. You seemed very tiny on the wind-swept mountainside. A twist of hair lay strung across your forehead, and your torn blue skirt clung to your tender thighs. You smiled through the blind white rain and gave me the salt kiss of your lips. Salt mingled with raindrop and mint and left me there where I had come to fetch you. So gallant in the blistering rain, and you ran home laughing, but it was worth the drenching. 2. Your feet, laved with dew, stood firm on the quickening grass. There was a butterfly between us, red and gold its wings, and heavy with dew. It could not move because of the weight of moisture. And as your foot came nearer, and I saw that you would crush it, I said, "Stay. It is only a few days in the sun, and we have many. And if I spare it?" You said, laughing. What will you do for me? What will you pay?
Why, anything you say.
And will you kiss my foot?
Both feet, I said, and did so happily, for they were no less than the wings of butterflies. 3. All night our love stole sleep from dusty eyes. What dreams were lost, I'll never know. It seemed the world's last night had come, and there would never be a dawn. Your touch soon swept the panting dark away. Some suns are brighter by the night than day. 4. Your eyes, glad and wondering, dwelt in mine, and all that stood between us was a blade of grass, shivering slightly in the breath from our lips. But grass will bend. We turn and kiss, and the world swings round. The sky spins, the trees go hush, hush, the mountain sings. Though we must leave this place, we have trapped forever in the trembling air, the last sweet phantom kiss. 5. I know you'll come when the cherries are ripe, but it's still November, and I must wait for the green fruit to blush, and meanwhile the tree is visited by robber bands, masked myenas, and yellow birds with beaks like daggers, determined not to leave one cherry whole for lovers. But still I wait, hoping one day you'll come to stain your lips with cherry juice and climb my tree. Bright goddess in your dark green temple, thrusting your tongue at me. 6. Slender waisted, bright as a song, dark as the whistling thrush at dawn, swift as the running days of November, lost like a dream, too sweet to remember. The love of two stars. Two stars fell in love. Between them came sky, and 10 moons and 2 suns riding high. Before them the nebulous star-crusted way, the silence of night, the silver of day. 1,000,000 years passed, the lovers still glowed with the brilliance and fire and passion of old. But one star grew restless and set off at night with a wonderful shower of hot white light. He sped to his love with his hopes and his fears, but missed her, alas, by 1,000 light years. Lovers observed. Lovers lie drowsy in the grass, sunk in bracken, swimming in pools of late afternoon sunshine. All agitation passed. They stay totally absorbed in grass. Green grass, and growing from that place, a sweep of languid arm still bare, but for a lost lady bird. Anonymous lover brushes a dragonfly from his face. Brief thunder blossoms in the air. A leaf between the thighs is caught and crushed. Love comes like a thief, crouching among the bruised and broken clover, all flesh in grass. Walnut tree. The walnut tree is the first to lose its leaves, but at the same time the fruit ripens, the skin splits, the hard shell of the nut stands revealed. Yesterday, the last of August, you climbed among the last few crumpled leaves. Slim boy in a walnut tree, your toes gripping the tender bark, your fingers fondling walnuts, while I waited and counted. And there were 23 walnuts on the grass. We cracked them open with our teeth. They were still raw, but we could not wait. The walnuts would age, and I might grow younger. Walnut tree revisited. You have ripened since last the walnut tree lost its dark leaves last autumn. One summer intervened between your growing and my importunity. One summer lost, while walnuts grew, I too had forgotten. We saw each other often, but gone was the magic of that first encounter, and even the tree gave little fruit last year. Now it stands bare-branched, outside the closed window, touched no more by feet and questing fingers, but turning its own fingers to the slanting winter sun. Not one leaf left, where hundreds glittered like spears in the forest of September. But I will wait until the parrots bring shrill portents of another spring, and I will love you with the same sweet pain if you and summer care to visit me again. Phantom lover, night unto night, when the world's asleep, you come to me, our tryst to keep. Held captive in thrall, as the stars look down, body and soul, from night unto dawn. Silent you come, and softly you go. Ours is a love that none must know. We must love someone. We must love someone, if we are to justify our presence on this earth. We must keep loving all our days, someone, anyone, anywhere outside ourselves. For even the saris crane will grieve over its lost companion, and the seal its mate. Somewhere in life, there must be someone to take your hand and share the torrid day. Without the touch of love, there is no life, and we must fade away. Love is a law.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.